Hey guys, welcome to the Aika Electricin user guide. And what we're gonna go through now is the normal mode, setting up a new experiment using the Electricin. So let's turn this guy on. And if you've watched these videos, you've probably already seen us go through the assist mode and how to set up a reaction using assist mode. And let's say you're kind of comfortable using assist mode and using Electricin, and you want to graduate on to setting up your own experiments. I'm going to show you how to run through this. So we can go to new experiments here. And again, we're going to run the same reaction. This is Yu Kawamata's electrochemical amination reaction. So we're going to click that in here right now. And here we have a number of options. We can set up a constant voltage reaction, a constant current reaction. We can also run a CV, which we're going to cover that in a later video. And so here I'm going to choose to run a constant current reaction. Click OK. First thing it's going to ask me is what my desired current is going to be. I said before, for this cell, we already know that it's been optimized to run at about 4 milliamps. So I set it to 4 and click OK. Here we're not using a reference electrode. If you'd like to use a reference electrode, you can put that in there and it'll actually show a referenced potential, but we do not need to do that. So we click No for reference electrode. And for the duration of the experiment is the next screen that pops up. And here we have three options. We can either run based on time, which gives us a time the reaction, pretty much a timer for when the reaction is supposed to stop off. We run total charge. Total charge is kind of similar to how assist mode was set up, and that's just based on the amount of charge corresponding to your set millimoles for your starting material. We can also have this run continuous. And if you run it continuous, it's just going to run pretty much until you decide to turn it off. And that can be useful for certain reactions that maybe take a long, you know, long time to run, or you're not sure how long can run, you're gonna be around and can check up on it, and that can be useful. So for here, we're just gonna choose to run this by time. And here I know this reaction, let's say it's gonna take, about 4.5 hours. So we can set the hours, set the minutes, and bring the seconds back to zero. And this is the amount of time that reaction is going to run. We click OK. The next thing it's going to do is ask us for the number of millimoles of substrate. And although you don't really need to use this because, again, the reaction is just based on the amount of current we're pumping through and it's for a set time, we input this in because it can help the user identify how many equivalents of electrons have been delivered to the reaction, or a number of Faradays per mole that have passed for the reaction. And here we know we're running at 20 millimoles of substrate. So we're going to click OK. And the next screen that pops up is alternating the polarity for the reactions. And normally we don't use this but for some reactions, including our electrochemical allylic oxidation reactions, we found that when you're using electrodes of the same composition on either side, that we actually get some fouling of the electrodes, or buildup on, let's say, the buildup of material on the cathode or buildup of material on the anode. And they're actually alternating the polarity periodically, let's say every 15 minutes or 5 minutes or 1 minute. That can help kind of stop that electrode fouling. So here, if you would like to do that, that is an option. You can do that using Electricin. For this case, we do not need to do that, especially because we're using a stainless steel cathode and a carbon anode. So we don't want to oxidize that cathode. I'm going to click No. And again, we do not want to save this experiment. I think it's easy enough to set up again. So we're going to click No. Here again, we come down to this main screen. Let's just check to make sure everything's okay. So it's a new experiment. It's a constant current electrolysis. We're running this at 4 milliamps. We do not have a reference electrode. The duration is going to be 4 hours and 30 minutes. And again, we're not going to alternate the polarity. Just a reminder, as I said before, here we have a minus on this side, and that designates that the counter electrode is going to be negatively charged, and a plus sign on this side designates that the working electrode on this side is going to be positively charged. And we have our stainless steel cathode there, and so that's exactly what we want. Again, if we want to edit the reaction, we can go in the edit screen, and we can edit any of these parameters as we please. We don't need to do that, so we're going to go to start, and the reaction can be running. And so here we see a couple things that are different from when we ran this using assist mode. We have a counter here, and this shows us how much time is remaining based on that 4 hours and 30 minutes we set. We also have the charge up here. And so based on the number of millimoles that I put in for this reaction, This is going to tell us the number of Faradays per mole that have passed through the reaction as it progresses. So that can be helpful kind of to adjust your stoichiometry and to kind of know maybe when reactions should be complete and what's going on in your reaction. Thanks, guys, and tune into the other videos if you have any other questions.